everyone. In this lecture, we are going to study about graphical or phasor representation of alternating quantity. Quantity having only magnitude are called as scalar quantity, while quantity having both magnitude and direction are called as vector quantity. When a vector quantity is represented by a straight line, it is called as a phasor. The line represents magnitude of the vector quantity, while its inclination to a reference line and the direction of the arrowhead represents the direction in which the vector acts. In this lecture, we will also be studying about phasor algebra, including addition, subtraction, and multiplication, division of alternating quantities. We will also be studying about J operator and calculation of polar to rectangular conversions using a calculator.
Let us study about phasor representation of an alternating quantity shown here. A vector OA is plotted at 0 point, that is starting point of the sine wave. OA1 vector is drawn at an instant of theta 1 having a theta 1 angle from the reference line. A vector OA2 is drawn with an angle of theta 2 at another instant. Vector OA3 is plotted at 90 degree with the reference line OA. The radius of OA, OA1, OA2, OA3 and so on remains same, and OA rotates in a counterclockwise representation for the sinusoidal quantity. If we consider a right-angled triangle OP1A1, we can write an equation as sine theta 1 is equal to A1P1 upon OA1. As the radius of all the vectors are same, we can replace OA1 as OA. That is, we can replace it as A1P1 as I1 and OA as maximum current IM. Hence, we get the equation as I1 is equal to IM sine theta 1. Let us consider two alternating quantities as shown here. One having a leading quantity with a current of 2.5 ampere, while another alternating quantity with a current of 2 ampere and having a lagging quantity. The phase difference between the two quantities is of angle theta. If a phasor diagram is plotted for the given sinusoidal equation, we can draw as for the leading quantity starting with 0 acts as the reference line. The length of the line, that is of 2.5 ampere, represents the magnitude of the vector quantity, while the another quantity lags with an angle theta and the length of the vector is 2 ampere. Let us study about phasor algebra, that is mathematical calculation of a vector quantity. Here, a reference of OA is given and OB at positive and negative half, that is OB positive and OB negative is shown. If we need to add the two vectors, that is OA and OB, a vector OC is drawn, which is equal to OC is equal to OA plus OB. If we need to subtract the two vectors, that is OA and minus OB, we obtain a vector OD, this is D, OD is equal to OA minus OB. The arrow represents that the given quantities are a vector quantity. Let us study about J operator. J operator has a value exactly equal to root over minus 1. J indicates anticlockwise rotation of a vector quantity. For a 90 degree rotation, the value of J, which is equal to root over minus 1, is given by plus J. For a 180 degree rotation, J value is given by J square, which is equal to square of root over minus 1, which is equal to minus 1. Rotation at a 270 degree, J value is given by J cube, that is cube of root over minus 1, which is equal to minus J. And for a 360 degree rotation, J operator is given by J to the power 4, which is equal to root over minus 1 raised to the power 4, which is equal to 1. Mathematical representation of phasor quantity is shown here. Let us consider two rectangular equations, that is A is equal to A plus JB and A minus JB. We will be using these equations for addition and subtraction of phasor quantity. Let us have the addition of two phasor quantities, that is A1 plus A2 is equal to vector A. On substituting the values, that is A1 plus JB1 plus A2 plus JB2, we separate real part and imaginary part, and we get A vector as A1 plus A2 plus J of B1 plus B2. The magnitude and angle of the quantities can be obtained as A is equal to root over square of real part and square of imaginary terms, while angle is obtained by theta is equal to tan inverse imaginary part upon real part. Subtraction of the phasor is obtained as A is equal to A1 minus A2. A1 is A1 plus JB1, while A2 is A2 plus JB2. On separating real and imaginary terms, we get A1 minus A2 plus J into B1 minus B2. The magnitude of the equation can be obtained as A is equal to root over square of real part plus square of imaginary part, while angle can be obtained as theta is equal to tan inverse imaginary part upon real part. For multiplication and division of phasor quantity, we consider polar form of the equation, that is A is equal to A at an angle theta, or A is equal to A at an angle minus theta. For the purpose of multiplication, we multiply the two polar equations. We get A1, A2 at an angle of theta theta 1 plus theta 2. We add the angular part of polar quantity for the purpose of multiplication, while for division we get A1 by A2 vector is equal to A1 at an angle theta 1 upon A2 at an angle theta 2. The angular part is subtracted for division.
A calculator with FX991ES series is used here to convert a rectangular equation into polar form and a polar equation into rectangular form. Consider an equation 2 plus 30i. We need to convert this equation into polar form. For doing so, set the calculator into compound mode, select polar, enter the numbers 2, 30, bracket close. On pressing equal to, we get r and theta value of polar equation. So the result is 30.06 at an angle 86.1859. Let us convert the obtained polar equation into rectangular form. For that, press rectangular, enter the numbers, that is 30.06, 86.18. On closing the bracket and pressing equal to, we get the result of rectangular as 2 plus 29.99 J, that is 30 J. So here we have converted the polar equation into rectangular form and obtained the result, that is 2 plus 30 J. This is how we perform conversion operation in calculator.